Good morning. It's Saturday, December 4th, and I was able to get what I wanted to get accomplished this morning already. Getting ready to fulfill my assignment as a top dasher. You might ask, what's a top dasher? That means when you turn on your app, any time of day, you can go out and work for DoorDash. Not everybody can do that. You got to work yourself into that position. But anyhow, wanted to share a song that meant a lot to me at a certain period in my life, 1978, and I met a young girl, and I wound up getting married to her and having three of her most beautiful children, Jessica the giraffe, Joshua the jaguar, and Timmy the tiger. This was a song that meant an awful lot to me, because I saw her coming to me in this way. Anyhow, here we go. Sometimes you don't get your cues right, your P's and Q's. But, if you have a teleprompter, anybody can look good, even Joe Biden. Where am I? They told me I'm supposed to wrap this up. Let me right now, my port sails stormy seas, battles oceans filled with tears. At last my port's in view, now that I discovered you. Oh, I'd give my life so lightly for my gentle lady. Give it freely and completely to my lady. As life goes drifting by like a breeze, she'll gently sigh and slowly bow her head. Then you'll hear her softly cry, "Oh, I'd give my life so lightly for my gentle lady. Give it freely and completely for my lady." Some people call me a ladies' man. When you're all alone, though actions speak louder than words, all I can say is I love you so, to drive away all my hurt. Oh, I'd give my life lately for my gentle lady. Give it freely and completely to my lady. Got dizzy. Here we go. Set sail before the sun. Feel the warmth that's just begun. Share each and every dream. They belong to everyone. Oh, I'd give my life so lightly for my gentle lady. Give it freely to my lady. Lady. This was the Moody Blues, and the songwriter was Ray Thomas. Give him the credit, and that was sung to the former Jacqueline Boring for her daughter, Jessica Ann Rogers Steins, Joshua Logan Rogers, and Timothy Michael Rogers. The whole entire Boring family, Sue Ellen, Jeannie, and all of those, Michael and Mary Kay out there in Washington, a very successful retired attorney. Life really does get moving really fast. You know, have you all noticed that? And I met a 70-year-old Hebraic Jewish lady in Hollywood. And she was going to her Hanukkah party last night. I don't even know her, but two of us have some crazy things in common, like the last four letters of her cell phone number, 5659, are the same last four numbers. Did I say letters? Four numbers of my Social Security number. You know, statistically, that's like 1 in 10,000 that you're going to line up numbers like that. I wonder what that means. She is pretty, too. Don't know her. And she's got cute little grandchildren as well. You know, how did we become grandparents? My grandparents used to be old. I guess in the eyes of some, I'm old, too. Well, signing off right now, and we'll sing that famous song that we did as kids. Happy trails to you and M-I-C. See you real soon. K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Remember, December 7th is coming up. A day that will live in infamy, and it will. December 7th, 1941. Hadn't it happened the way that it happened, I might not be here today. Because Dad took his assignment seriously. The rage and anger that he had towards Hitler caused him to fly 35 missions as a co-pilot in the B-17, and then he re-upped so that he could fly the P-51 Mustang, and then he got vapor lock engine problems and had to bail out over Germany. His tree. He landed in a tree, and his plane destroyed pretty much a guy's farm. He told me one night while drinking with Pat Corey as a witness, but Pat's not here any longer either because of Agent Orange, and we were in the Navy Reserve together with his older brother, Charlie. A lot of this is documented, but people don't know it. Documented in the recesses of my mind, it doesn't matter where. I can recall things. I can recall exactly the crackling fire. I know where he was sitting in the captain's chair. Ask Mutta. Anyhow, that he was more concerned about the farmer and the pitchfork than the stormtroopers that came to get him. Because, you know, they had certain obligations to either take him out and shoot him in, which he was concerned that was going to happen. So he had already chosen the one he was going to take out with him. Dad was a pistol. But not until he met Jesus did he really know what fear was before his ticket to ride, his free ticket. We'll all talk soon. Love you all. Bye-bye.